Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I'll just run you through the normal social media activity during the press conference. We'll just start with broadcast questions with Roger, and then move on to the dailies briefing, which is embargoed till 10:30 tonight. Roger, just go.
Hi,
Bruce. Hi, hello.
First of all, team news on Toby Alderweireld. Can we expect to see him back against Watford?
Yes, he's training well today. His recovery from the virus that he got one day before the game against Southampton. And yes, but I don't want to say nothing because if not, you take in a different way. Because before the Southampton game, I said, because I think it was the press conference 5 days before the game, because it was Christmas, no? I don't want to disturb you. But he was recovering for his problem in his back. For that, he didn't play again Burnley, but he got a bite one day before. We can do about that. And now he's recovering, and we hope that we'll be available for Watford. But today is okay.
Any other concerns, any new injuries or anyone?
No, Lamela is still recovering from his problem. He's doing well, but now we need to wait. He's recovering his fitness and his level. But no another problem.
You've got Chelsea a few days after Watford as well, as a quick turnaround between the two games. Do you pick your side against Watford with perhaps Chelsea in mind as well?
No, because I think for us the most important game is Watford. It's important to try to reduce the gap with the top four. On the end, keep the same gap, and I think it's important. I think we need to be focused. We need to be focused in Watford because I think are the most important point now for us.
10 points behind Chelsea at the moment, and everyone around you keeps winning as well, even though you're winning as well. Is 10 points almost too much even already at this stage, too big a gap to think about closing?
I think that it's a lot of way ahead. I think it will be tough for all the contender. Chelsea have a very good gap now, a big gap with the second, and 10 points with us. But I think it's not decisive. We need to believe. We are fighting for that to try to reduce the gap, and we have sure a very good opportunity when we will play with them. But first of all, we need to win. We need to win. We must win again. Watford, very important 3 points, and then we see what happens with another team that are with us. But it's a lot of game ahead. It's nearly the half season. It's a long way.
Just got a couple of days, of course, until the window opens. And of course, Tottenham have been linked with a lot of players. Can I ask you about a name that's come up in the last couple of days, Ross Barkley? Is there an interest there? Is he a player that you admire?
No, you know, always appear a lot of names, a lot of rumour in that period. I don't like to speak about names, about rumours.
We're always going to keep on asking that. Isco is another one as well. You had interest in him before, and it seems to feel like the future is uncertain. If there is an availability there for Isco, is he a player you're still interested in?
About?
Isco.
No, yes, it was another rumour in summer that another name, but they are in their clubs, and I think I don't like to talk about rumor because I cannot confirm or not, or yes, if we are interested or not. I think that is we need to be professional, and we need to do our job. You know that we are always open to try to add quality in our squad, but to talk about names or rumor, I think it's not professional.
Do you expect to bring people, either one player, two players in before the January window?
No. I don't expect to do some business because I am happy with the squad that we have, and I think it's not the right moment. Only if appears some possibility that will benefit us. If not, no.
The sort of players that people are mentioning, the likes of Barkley, the likes of Isco, the sort of attacking, creative midfielder. I mean, Would that be an area where that isn't a priority, given the form that, say, Dele Alli is in at the moment?
Yes, it's for that. I don't know if, from where come that that rumor. It's not sure for myself or for my staff, that is sure. And then if some people from the club create that rumor, I don't know. Or if coming from outside, I don't know. It's for that we are very calm, very consistency with our philosophy and the way that we are developing our game. And you know, we cannot stop the rumor, and we cannot confirm this every time that appears one rumor if it's true or not true, you know.
Just on Dele Alli and his form, some people earlier in the season saying he perhaps hadn't recaptured the form of last season, but would you say in the last couple of weeks he's perhaps hit his highest levels again?
Well, I was happy with him. Only, do you know, the young player need to every day to try to improve, to get more experience. I think Dele Alli have a big potential to improve. And I think it is impossible to keep the same level and the level that he was playing, that was very high, whole season. Sometimes you have some. You can drop your performance, but no doubt about that he is and he will be one of the best players in the next 10, 12 years on England.
Just in terms of what we talked about, potentially whether there'll be players coming in, going out, and the big talk of Kevin Wimmer, who hasn't been playing a huge amount. Is he going out on loan at all? Or
No. We are not talking about that internally. And for me, I am happy with him. He's still very young. When we bring him, was not only for present, if not for future. And we are very happy with him. It's not my point to discuss about him.
And do you see a situation where there could be players going out in the transfer window? Or you said you're happy with this?
I don't expect that the player go out to the squad. On January. I think it's no sense.
Okay. Maurizio, we were listening to Arsene Wenger this morning, who said that the first half of the season in general for the Premier League has been rather disappointing in terms of the quality of the matches overall. Would you agree with him that this has been a slightly below par Premier League season?
First of all, I didn't hear his press conference, and I cannot speak about the thing that I didn't see. And for me, the Premier League is the most tough competition. My opinion always is difficult. I think the quality is good here, and then everyone can have the opinion, and you need to respect all the opinion. But my point of view, for me, the Premier League is the most tough competition. I come from Spain, I was in France. I follow the different competition like Bundesliga or Italy or Argentina. And I think England, we are on the top.
Halfway through the season, how would you rate Spurs' performance in the Premier League? Would you say that it has been okay? Good or excellent?
I don't know. It's up to you how they want to qualify, judge the season. I don't know. To be fair, it's difficult to judge. If we compare with last season, in that point we have four more points than last season, but we are fifth. Last season we were four. Maybe the people can have different opinion, maybe better or maybe worse. I don't know. I think that for different reason that we know inside, I think the season, in a fair period of the season, I think we feel disappointed because we are out of the Champions League and that we cannot hidden. But I think in Premier League we are doing well. We can do better, of course. We are ambition, of course, and we can improve, yes. But I think that season, the expectation was massive on the beginning, And to be out of the Champions League is a little bit disappointed, not only us, if not our supporter too, and maybe that feeling is not so good, maybe how show the numbers, because I think in 2016, I think we broke the record and 71 points, and I think we can be happy, but for different reason, it's not 100% the full happiness, no?
There's been another story overnight linking Cristiano Ronaldo
with us,
with China, not with you, but with going perhaps to China or a big bid which Real Madrid has turned down. Should the Premier League be worried about losing some of its best players to China?
I think no, because if the player they have in their mind to move to China to play, I think it's because they don't have nothing to do here. Okay, because I think you can't compare both league. Only you can move for different reasons that you know all and we know all. And if you don't want to be in the best league of the world and to be competitive and feel the competition, is because in your mind you want. You consider it different thing before to play football. But that is, I respect all the decision, but it's for that we cannot be worried.
But is there not a day when the amounts of money will turn people's heads, players' heads, to think that I can earn so much by going to play there that I will do?
Yes, but that is a personal matter and personal decision. Do you know? The people, we have all different vision about life, about money, about enjoy life and happiness and different things. And you cannot be inside to the people that pick one or another way. It's for that is my point of view, myself, I never will move to another league for money. I like to be here maybe for less money, but that is, I respect how the people respect my opinion. I respect the different opinion and decision.
Are you presumably happy that the FA won't be taking any action against Yann Vertonghen?
Yeah, but it was an action, I think, the clip, maybe, on the first moment you can see, okay, maybe it wasn't intentional, but wasn't intentional. And the reaction of Shea Rodriguez, I think was he was very fair play with Jean, and then they talk, and was an action that wasn't maybe it looks bad, but after that I think when you review again, was an action that maybe you don't realize, and no, happy that any action from the FA to Jean. And I think I want to say that the behavior of Che Rodriguez, the fair play, like a teammate or like a player, was fantastic.
Is that something we need to see more of in football? Just players getting on with it, not making...
Yes, but do you know, it's too difficult to keep calm in that moment. And but it's true, yes. In football, we need more chest action like this to try to understand both sides. But sometimes it's difficult, eh? I understand too when some players behave differently. No?
Any more broadcast questions? No, if the camera's off, please. Thank you.
Thank you.